So I grew up and started comedy in Chicago, and that meant I got to drive around a lot in the Midwest, which was great. There's a lot of amazing places to do comedy in the Midwest, and one of them is Bloomington, Indiana. If you've never been, Bloomington, Indiana is one of the most amazing little utopia college towns in the world. But to get to it, you have to drive through Indiana, which is very bad. It's very bad, Indiana. I'm sorry, Indiana, but I've driven all throughout you, and you're terrifying. You're really terrifying. I once did a show in Indianapolis at a college. It's like one of the biggest cities in the country. And he's like, oh, it's just a wasteland of fucking Mad Max shit going on. There is. That's true. That was the correct reaction in Indianapolis. Because after the show, I was like, hey, I kind of want to go see a midnight movie or something. My adrenaline's kind of still going. I was like asking the little group of college kids who booked me, like, hey, where's a cool place to like go see a movie? They're like, don't go to the city after 8 o'clock. Everything's closed except for 24-hour gun shops. You will die. If you come back to the dorms, we'll let you eat some of our pretzels, but you should probably go to bed. Oh, God. Oh. There's so many little cities where it's like, if there's one city that shall go nameless because I don't want them to hunt me down. But I was driving to it to do a show, and there's this guy. We should probably cut this from the CD too, because I'm really afraid of these people. Like, really afraid. Like, you have no idea. There's this guy, Tom Raper, who runs the city of Richmond, Indiana. And as you're driving towards Richmond, Indiana, you start to see a bunch of billboards saying, Tom Raper, Tom Raper, Tom Raper. Because he's this Republican Tea Party guy with tons of money who like poured all of it into this college. And he is like there to force his name into your periphery. Like if that's your name as a child, I'm sure it became a bad thing amongst your social group. Why, when you turn 18, is the first thing you do just not, well, that's not my name anymore. Fuck this. What, was he really like, oh, Raper, that used to mean smithing rope. I think that's great to stand by. I'm going to found a company of tractor trailers and trailer parks and doorknobs and run a city and make everyone sign a paycheck that says Raper Industries. But he does. That's Indiana. So to get to Bloomington, you have to drive through horror. And not only did I go there for a bunch of shows, but some of my best friends, Caitlin and Devin, got married in Bloomington, Indiana. And my wife and I drove out there to go see them get married. Their parents had this great little like house in the woods. There's this great clearing where they got married. It's beautiful. And we decided we would stay, you know, just outside of Bloomington. And we went for this little drive. And the woods are so thick around Bloomington. And you can just feel the shape of the country pointing here and just saying, don't go here. Don't, like you know, like the Appalachian Mountains just kind of like here's a little bit of hillbilly will just smear across the center of the country like a, I don't know, a belt or something. And so we're driving around the woods and, you know, like all of a sudden it just gets kind of dark from all the foliage, and like I realized the window was rolled down. I looked on my shoulder, there's a moth like the size of a pigeon. It like whispered in my ear, turn around. And we drove past this gas station that had been turned into a yard sale depot / home. We were in Gnawbone, Indiana. G-N-A-W, Bone, Indiana. If you look this up on the internet, no one's quite sure why it's called Gnawbone, Indiana. There's a couple of theories. One, it's gross. Two, they thought, the Native American tribes thought that was where like scavenger people went to just chew on meat that they'd stolen. Gnawbone, Indiana. And the population is like, you know, it's like 50 people, and they're all just these mud golems, just these strange hill people, wanderer types. And so I see this gas station turned yard, because that's like, also if you look this up, it's, please look up Gnawbone, Indiana. Their like main source of income is like yard sales. we're driving past this former gas station, and there's these blankets laid out in the crumpled concrete and gravel, and there's these gargoyles that they're selling. These plaster cast gargoyles are laid out on these blankets. And I turned to my wife and I was like, I think I want to buy a gargoyle. I bet these are super cheap. And she went, I'm staying in the car. Hurry up. So I pulled over and I get out of the car and I look like an idiot. I look like a total urban idiot. Like at the time, I think my hair was blue and, you know, I was wearing like a punk band t-shirt and just super idiot. Like I was going to get dressed up later. I was like, hey, I'm going to wear my city clothes and just drive around Indiana. Blah. So I walk up to this person thing. The bottom half of their clothes, I'm pretty sure, are like the hospital scrub pants, but like modified a little bit. Like to have pockets, but like we're definitely from a hospital. And this shirt that was, it had, you know, gangster Tweety Bird on it, for why ever that's a thing, airbrushed. And it was inside out. So it both gave the impression of that like Blair Witch Project thing where like it's turned around and like speaking to the devil and like its back is to you because it's gonna turn around and slice your throat, but also like you could still see its eyes. So it was like inviting you to like stare through its eyes into the shapeless body beneath the shirt. So this person thing comes up to me as I walk up to the person thing. And I look at this gargoyle, it was super huge, it was like 50 pounds and it said $10 and a little card next to it. I said, hey, I want to buy that gargoyle. This is great. And she goes, it was probably a woman. And so it goes, oh yeah? Y'all, and like it did that thing where it started laughing, but like it was more like something I gathered from observations than like a human connection I made with the laughter. Like its face was shaking, its chin was moving, but there was no expression on its face. Like it was just like, and it said, yeah, you like monsters? Yeah. I mean, that's why I want to get a cargo. I like monsters. Yeah, sure. I think they're cool. I want to buy a $10 monster. Yeah, sure. I got some angels in the basement. Okay, so the first thing that runs through my head is best case scenario, she has kidnapped children. She's kidnapped children, they're in her basement. That's what she's talking about. And worst case scenario, of course, obviously, you know, there's a crack in the earth that leads directly to hell, and she's talking about a real angel that she has in shackles. It's one of those two. So I'm just absolutely terrified, and of course I buy the gargoyle still and I get out of there. But I thought about it later. It was an abandoned gas station. There's no fucking way that thing had a basement. What? What are you talking about? No! If Pee Wee Herman taught me anything, you should always be suspicious of a strange structure's existing basement. The Alamo did not have a bicycle, and she did not have an angel in her basement. At best, there was like a hollowed out gasoline tank where she like, just like a pile of bones.